creepiest things ever found by deep sea divers. Hey everyone, it's Alexa again, and welcome back to another video. Remains of fallen ships, strange creatures, mysterious monuments, unique phenomena. Who knew you could find all these things in the darkness of the ocean? Here are some of the intriguing and eerie sights those who have dared to explore our mysterious seas have found. But before we get into today's video, make sure that you're subscribed and ring the bell so that you never miss any of our upcoming videos. The pythons of the sea. Most people who have come across an oarfish have only seen one after it has washed up on shore. However, these large, long fish live in the deepest reaches of the sea. Oarfish measure up to 36 feet long, making them the longest living species of bony fish. They have 400 dorsal fin rays, and their eyes are huge, which you need if you live in such a dark environment. When they're alive, blue and black stripes and dots cover their bodies. Upon death, these marks will fade. You'll find these slithery fish swimming as far down as 3,300 feet. They need to live this deep because of their lack of muscle mass. The movement from shallower waters is too much for their body to handle, and they cannot survive. Scientists did not describe the oarfish until 1772. Throughout the years, encounters with divers have been rare. What can these long fellows do? Researchers in New Zealand claim that the oarfish emits electric shocks when touched. In the eye. When a mysterious eye was recovered from the sea in 2012, it baffled many scientists. The eyeball was about as big as a softball and appeared as if someone cut it from whatever animal it belonged to. Biologists from the Florida Fish and Wildlife Commission spent weeks trying to identify what fish this eye came from. At first, people thought it must be from a giant squid. However, it was George Burgess of the Florida Museum of Natural History in Gainesville that suggested it was most likely the eye of a large female swordfish. That swordfish must have weighed half a ton and measured more than 10 feet long. A piece of the Apollo. There have been six Apollo missions. The first was Apollo 11, which landed the first two people on the moon, Commander Neil Armstrong and module pilot Buzz Aldrin. This mission happened in 1969 and took 8 days and 3 hours to complete. During its takeoff, the Apollo 11's rocket engine detached after takeoff and landed somewhere on Earth. 4 years later, Amazon founder Jeff Bezos finds this missing piece. Bezos has always been a fan of science and space. That's why he started his exploration company, Bezos Expeditions. Now, decades later, his team recovered the rocket engine from the Atlantic Ocean. The rocket measured 12.2 feet wide by 18.5 feet tall. It sank 14,000 feet beneath the ocean's surface. The unarmed stomach. There is a variety of fish that lives in the deep sea known as Anoplogastridae. Colloquially, they are known as fangtooths. Their taxonomic family name comes from the Greek words for unarmed and stomach. Proportionately, their heads and teeth are quite large, but when you compare their overall size to that of a person, their size is pretty small. Their sharp, needle-like dentations are harmless to humans. Still, the sight of them is pretty frightening. On their round heads are little beady eyes, and their mouths open up to serrated cavities. Most living 16,000 feet deep, though some dwell closer to 660 feet. Fangtooth fish look similar to many other fish that live at these depths, such as viperfish and anglerfish. Find some treasure. Instead of pirates from the 18th century sailing from Europe to the Caribbean, we're going to take time slightly more recent. For this next topic, we go back to World War II. After the Germans sunk a British merchant ship in the Atlantic Ocean, the vessel's haul of 61 tons of silver went with it. That silver was in the form of 1,574 silver ingots, weighing 1.8 million ounces. The ship was the SS Gersoppa, which was torpedoed by a U-boat in 1941. The Odyssey expedition discovered the shipwreck in 2011, 300 miles off the coast of Ireland. The whole find was worth $36 million. Spider or crab? When we think of marine animals, we generally think of things that swim. However, we should remember that there are creepy crawlies down there too. What do you get when you cross the appearance of a spider and a crab and then drop that animal into the sea? The answer is a Japanese giant spider crab. This species of marine crab has legs akin to an arachnid. Their legs grow 18 feet, the largest leg span of any arthropod. In Japanese culture, the spider crab is a delicacy. Though they take up a lot of space, their bumpy exoskeletons help them camouflage into the seafloor. Western science first described these crabs in 1836 near the artificial island of Dejima. Down with Coolidge. The SS President Coolidge was a luxury ocean liner that was completed in 1931 and stayed in service until 1942. This massive vessel had a length of 615 feet and could travel at 21 knots. In 1940, America used this luxury ship to evacuate U.S. citizens from Hong Kong. The ship met its demise 2 years later. Captain Henry Nelson feared the boat would fall into the hands of the Japanese. He ran the ship aground and ordered his troops to abandon the Coolidge. After its sinking, divers looted bunker oil, electric motors, copper tubing, and more from the ship. In 1983, the Vanuatu government declared it illegal to salvage any artifact from the Coolidge. Now, it's a site used for recreational diving. The giant squid. You're gonna need a plate the size of a long table for this platter of calamari. Giant squids are another instance of deep sea gigantism. The maximum confirmed size of these aquatic beasts is 42 feet long. They are the largest of all invertebrates, only exceeded by the colossal squid, which has a mantle or head twice as long. Researchers have debated how many different giant squid species there are, though the most recent data suggests only one exists. The river in the sea. You'll find the Black Sea between Romania, Ukraine, Turkey, Bulgaria, and a handful of other European countries. It is a marginal sea of the Atlantic Ocean, and major rivers such as the Danube and the Kuban are sourced from the Black Sea. There is an additional river, but it is not on land like you would expect. Under the surface of the Black Sea, you'll find the appropriately named Undersea River. The Undersea River is a current that flows along the seabed. Scientists at the University of Leeds discovered it in 2010, saying it is the first of its kind in the world. Why the sad face? By now, you've probably seen an image of a blobfish before. People love to make fun of how strange and dopey they look. Humans haven't known about the blobfish for that long. Its discovery was as recent as 2003, just 16 years ago. The blobfish is a deep-sea fish that inhabits the regions near mainland Australia, Tasmania, and New Zealand. They typically swim at depths between 2,000 and 3,900 feet. Here, the pressure is 60 to 120 times greater than at sea level. The difference in pressure explains their lumpy looks. In their natural habitat, they look more or less like regular fish, but bring them into shallower waters and their bodies respond to the lighter pressure by looking like this. SOS from the RMS Titanic. The Titanic is possibly the most famous ship to ever set sail. It was a British passenger liner, one that carried over 2,000 people. At the time, the RMS Titanic was the largest ship afloat, and aboard were some of the wealthiest people in the world at the time. If you remember the movie, all the rich people had rooms near the top, while the third-class passengers slept in the cramped areas near the lower levels of the ship. The Titanic sank in 1912, riding from Southampton, the UK, to New York City. Of those 2,200 passengers, less than 800 made it out alive. The US military discovered the wreckage in the Atlantic in 1985, over 70 years after its tragic end. The Yonaguni Monument. While trying to observe hammerhead sharks, the director of the Yonaguni-Cho Tourism Association, Masaaki Kimura, came across one of the most mysterious sea discoveries yet. Kimura found rock formations that appear to be human-made monoliths. Why does Kimura think they are not natural features? Much of the rock seems perfect in shape, as if someone carved them. Divers will come across two pillars called twin megaliths, columns, a straight wall, a formation known as the turtle. Some scientists who have studied Yonaguni argue that these are most likely natural emergences of rock that may have been used and modified by past humans. What ancient humans could have done here, under the water, remains a mystery. The Antikythera mechanism. When the device known as the Antikythera mechanism was first extracted from the sea near the Greek island of, you guessed it, Antikythera, no one was sure what the ancient Greeks used it for. Following its discovery in 1901, this artifact had long eluded researchers when it came to its purpose. Now, most agree that it is an ancient analog computer that predicted planetary positions and eclipses. Experts consider it the first known analog computer dating back to the Hellenistic period, around 323 to 31 BCE. Waterfall in the water. It may seem as though the Earth is falling into itself and it's the end of the world, but relax. That is what many people call a waterfall in the water. Now, how does water fall in the water? Trick question, it doesn't. But it can look that way. The so-called underwater waterfall can be found off the coast of Lemoorn, the southwest of Mauritius. What you see is not water flowing down, but sand and silt on the ocean floor that is running off. From above the sea, it looks like a waterfall. Like a termite. If the sight of an isopod makes your skin crawl, don't worry. You're not alone. The image of a larger-than-life termite would scare almost anyone. Over 20 species of giant isopods exist. You'll find them in abundance, living in the cold waters of the Indian Indian, Pacific, and Atlantic Oceans. Biologists call them pill bugs, as they are similar to roly-polies. Their enormous size is attributed to a phenomenon we talked about earlier, deep-sea gigantism, or abyssal gigantism. The inky Dracula. The name vampire squid sounds menacing, but when you see how big the cephalopod is, you probably won't be so scared. Vampire squids measure 1 foot at the most, counting their tentacles. Its body is 6 inches long. The vampire squid is similar to octopuses and squids, but isn't quite either. When first discovered in the 1900s, German teuthologist Carl Chun originally described it as an octopus. Because of its inability to fit perfectly into either of these categories, biologists place the vampire squid into its own order. Pyromorphida. This inky Dracula uses its light-producing organs, called photophores, to disorient other creatures it perceives as a threat. All right, we'll tell you number one in just a second, but first you've got to answer a question for us. Which of these two things are more mysterious to you? The deep sea or outer space? Where do you think most of humanity's time and efforts should go into exploring? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. 1. The lost city of Heraklion. Was Atlantis real? In a way, yes, but not exactly how we thought. There was an old city that once existed on land that is now at the bottom of the sea. That place is known as the Lost City of Heraklion. Heraklion was near the canopic mouth of the Nile, northeast of Alexandria. The Egyptians called this place Thonis. Its origins trace back to the 12th century BC. French underwater archaeologist Frank Godillo first discovered the ruins in 1999 after searching for it for 5 years. What secrets does this fallen city hold? Archaeologists have recovered statues, walls, and artifacts like gold coins from the ruins of Thonis Heraklion. It appears that the town succumbed to soil liquefaction and lost its stability after several tsunamis and earthquakes.